Okay, today we will start our sixth unit, that is, this is Jodi's farm. This is already the lesson was taken before, so now let us go through the lesson again, because it was before the exam. I think you all have forgotten about it, isn't it? So now let me start the lesson once again. Okay, so this is Jodi's farm. That is the lesson what we are going to do. Often, instead of rushing to the doctor to treat a small cut or burn, we find quick and effective cures using things available at home, isn't it? So if some small injury or hurt or anything or a cut, suppose we are cutting something, vegetables or something, and all of a sudden a small cut comes in your finger, do you run to the doctor first? No, you are not going to run to the doctor, isn't it? First we will put some medicine which is available at home. So first aid we will give from home only, isn't it? After that only, if it is serious, will be taken to the hospital. Clear to you? So here also something had happened to Jodi's father, and now we will see what is the first aid given to that person. That is what we are going to study in the lesson. And here some are given, suppose a cut on your knife or a cut on your knee. That means you are running in the playground and suddenly you have fallen down, a small injury had happened on your knee. What you will do? If it is very serious one, if the cut is very big, then after all, after we first work, we will not with that dirt, we will not take it to the hospital, isn't it? What you will do? We will first wash it, being with the dead towel, and then we can put some, first we can put some antibiotic ointment over it, isn't it? So after that, taken to the hospital. A burn on your arm, for that also what antibiotic ointment is there at home, we used to take it and rub over it. A honey is a good example for that. If honey is available, we take honey and we rub over there, isn't it? Or even toothpaste, that is also a good medicine for burning. First you apply, we can do it. A bee sting, suppose a bee is there and it is giving, or we will take out the sting first and that also we can apply something on that. In this story, Jodi's father has been bitten by a rattlesnake. So here, the rattlesnake is there. So what we will do if a snake bites? First we have to tie up tightly. We have to tie that portion, the above portion, that is where the cut is there, and the above portion we have to tie tightly, very tightly. So why we are tying it very tightly? Yes, because the blood circulation has to be stopped over there, isn't it? Otherwise what happened? The bitten portion, it is poisonous, and that poison will pass to the blood. So we have to stop over there. The circulation of the blood has to be stopped over there. And then all that the blood which is being, where the bite is there, that has to go out, isn't it? But we will not keep for a long time. The next moment the person has to be taken to the hospital. Jodi's father, he quickly kills a doe and uses its heart. So here the first aid was given by taking the doe and then using heart, taking doe and his heart and the liver. Heart and liver is taken out and given to that person who is being bitten by a snake. So that is also a good medicine. Jodi wonders what will happen to the little fawn kept without a mother. So this is the mother deer and this is the baby one. Baby deer. And this is the mother. So now that the mother is the grown up one, isn't it? From that what is being taken out, arm and liver is being taken out and it is used as a medicine for whose father? Jodi's father. And so who is left over there? The baby here is left over there. Now Jodi wanted to find out where that baby and he did not want to let the baby be alone. He wanted to take it. Understood now? Now we go to the story. Jodi allowed his thoughts to drift back to the farm. So after giving medicine to his father and not staying, his mind is way to that poor animal. Isn't it? Because the mother and the baby was together and they had taken home. The mother, they had killed the mother one. And so who is left without the mother? The baby is left without the mother. So he was thinking, who is there to take care of that baby? He could not keep it out of his mind. So always he was thinking that he cannot put that away from his mind, because it is coming very clear to his mind that what is happening to that small baby. He had a held him in his dreams in his arms. He slipped from the table and went to his father's bedside. So he could not concentrate on that. So what did he do? He went to his father. Penny lay at rest. So who is his father? Penny. Penny is the father. He is lying, taking rest. His eyes were open and clear, but the pupils were still dark and dilated. That means he had not overcome, isn't it? He had not overcome from that great danger. So he was lying rest. Understood? Jodi said, "How are you feeling, Pa?" So he went to his father and asked, "How is he feeling?" Just to find some old death had gone living elsewhere. But was it eaten? Crochet. That means crochet means it was a narrow escape. A narrow escape. Why did he say to be a narrow escape? Why did he say to be a narrow escape? Because the snake has bitten. At that very moment, medicine was brought and given. Isn't it? Otherwise, what will happen to Penny? He will die. Isn't it? So who had saved that? Jodi had saved that. I agree, Penny said, I'm proud of you, boy, the way you kept your head and did what was in your mind. The boy, how you kept your head, that means thinking. How did you think in that very point, he thought about taking the heart and the liver off a doe. So the doe is not at home, isn't it? The deers are in the forest. So he ran to the forest to get that mother. A deer and have taken the heart and liver, killed the animal, taken the heart and the liver, and he made medicine and given to his father. And whose life is saved now? Jodi's father's life is saved now. But who is left without the mother? The baby is left without the mother, isn't it? So even though he had come to his father and now his father is okay, still he was thinking about that baby whom he had taken the mother away, isn't it? Clear to you? Okay. Jodi allowed his thoughts to drift back to the farm. He could not keep it out of his mind. He has held it in his dreams, in his arms. He slipped from the table and went to his father's bedside. When he lay at rest, his eyes were open and clear, but the pupils were still dark and dilated. Jodi said, "How are you feeling, Pa?" Just fine, son. Old death has gone driving us. So that means from my body, what who had gone, death had gone. But wasn't it is a crucial, but it was a narrow escape. I agree, Penny said. I am proud of you, boy, the way you kept your head and did what was needed. So the father was proud of whom? Jodi. Why? Because at that critical moment, he thought about how to save his father, isn't it? And he had saved the life of his father. Pa, yes, son, Pa, do you recollect the doe and the fox? So he is asking his father, are you remembering about that mother and the baby? isn't it? Baby deer, yes. I cannot protect them. The poor doe saved me. This is certain. Pa, the fawn may be out there yet. It might be hungry and very scared. So what did he say? I can never forget them. The poor doe saved me. That is certain. That means I was in the stage of dying, isn't it? That the poor mother deer had saved my life. But who was left? The fawn was left. That is a great pity thing, isn't it? The baby was there and the mother had been killed. The poor doe saved me, that is certain. So father is saying that that poor animal had saved my life. Father, the fawn may be out there, which might be hungry and very scared. But Jodi was saying, father said that mother deer had saved my life, isn't it? But Jodi is saying that poor thing, the poor baby, isn't it? The fawn will be now hungry. And also scared, he will be frightened because who is not there? Mother is not there, isn't it? It is only a baby, hungry and very scared. Scared means frightened. Scared, frightened. So say that now the poor fawn will be very frightened and scared. I suppose so. So when he is saying yes, because we have taken the mother, isn't it? I am a big boy now and don't need to drink milk. Why don't I go and see if I can find the fawn? So now he is saying that I had grown up. Now I am a big boy and I don't need milk. So what did he understand? What did he wanted to say to his father? Yes, he wanted to say that let me give the milk what I am drinking to whom? To that fawn. So I have to bring that fawn to our house. Isn't it? He wanted to bring that fawn to his house. Why? Because it is only a baby and now it is not getting milk from his mother. Isn't it? What happened to the mother? The mother is being killed by them. So the baby is left there. Now nobody is there to take care of that baby. So Jodi is saying that I am grown up now, I don't need milk. Let me give the milk to whom? To this one, because it will feel hungry and also same time frightened. And pouring it there and raise it. When he lay quiet staring at the ceiling, so he wanted to bring that fawn at home. Boy, you have got me empty. So Papa Penny could not say anything. Because he also know that poor baby will be there hungry and also at the same time frightened because they have taken the mother away. They have killed the mother. It won't take much to raise it up. It will soon start eating leaves and acorns. That means only for some time it is a baby. So now we can give that baby milk and after that what happens? It will start eating grass. Slowly, slowly it will start eating grass, isn't it? So what happens? The only thing is he wanted to bring it and now it has to be given milk. After some time we can give leaves and slowly slowly it will start eating leaves and apples. You are smarter than boys of your age. So father was very proud saying that this much you are thinking about that animal. We took its mother and it was into blame. That means we should not blame who? That baby. We should not allow the baby to be hungry, isn't it? Why? Because we had killed its mother. Surely it seems ungrateful to leave it to starve. So we should not allow that baby to starve there. Son, I can say no to you. I never thought I would live to see another thing. So father was saying that I did not think all about that. The only thing is now I am alive, but the poor baby lost its mother. Can I ride back with the mill and see if I can find it? So he is all saying that you allow me to go with the home. Allow me to go with the mill. So he will take me to the place where he had left the fawn. I can find it. So saying that I can go with the Melville and he will help me to find that form. So finding the form is not the only thing. He wanted to bring home also. Understood? That means wanted to take care of that animal. Tell your mom, I said you can go. So father had allowed him, okay, then you can go and save that animal. So for that, before going, you should get permission from your mother also. He said it back to the table and sat down. His mother was pouring coffee for everyone. He went to the mother to get the permission. He said, Mom, Pa says I can go bring back the farm. So he went and said, now father is saying I can go and bring that farm. She got the coffee pot in midair. What farm? The farm belonging to the doe we killed. We used the doe's liver to draw the poison and save father. He said that we had killed the mother of that baby and now he is left alone there. And now who had come back to life? Our father had come back to life. She did not know what to do. Well, for pity's sake, I will say, Pa says it would be ungrateful to leave it to starve. That means we should not make that animal starve over there. That means die without food. Though Wilson said, that is right, Mom. Madam, nothing in the world comes quite free. The boy is right and he is right. Melville said, I can ride back with me. I will help him find it. That means Melville also was ready saying that he is ready. He will go with the Judy to find the animal and bring it home. She sat down the pot helplessly. But if you will give it your milk, we will got nothing else to feed. That means now we can give only milk. Melville come on boy, we will get to get riding. That means now both the boys started going to the forest finding the farm. Mr. Ma walks around anxiously. You will not be gone long. That means you should not go to the interior part of the forest. Jody said, I will be back before dinner for sure. That means I will come back before night. Melville mounted his horse and pulled Jody up behind him. So they started their journey. Where? How? In a horse. He said to Melville, do you think the fawn is still there? Will you help me find him? We will find him if he is alive. How do you know it is a he? So he wanted to know, he had said that it is a male one, isn't it? So he asked, how do you know that it is a male baby? The spots were all in a lion. That means the spots are there on the body of the deers, isn't it? So he said, when the spots are in a shown like in a lion, down the door from passes the spots are every which way on a door. The spots are all in a line, then it is a dog. That means it is a girl. And if it is a boy, it will be anywhere. The spots will be like a scattered in the body. Understood? It should not, it will not resemble like a line. So that much you understood. So what had happened to Jody's father? So what happened to Jody's father? Yes, he was bitten by a rabbit snake. By a snake. Jody's father was bitten by a rabbit snake. Now, how did the doe save Penny's life? He had extracted the heart and the liver of the doe and given to his father. That means they are used to extract the poison from the body. Why does Jody want to bring the fawn? Because he did not want the fawn to die of starvation. To die of starvation and fear. Because it is only a baby, isn't it? So the mother is being killed and the baby is left alone. So it will not get milk to drink. As a result, what happens? It will die of starvation and at the same time having the fear also, isn't it? So we did not want the baby born to die of starvation and fear. Now, how does Jody know that the fawn is a male? How does lines are the spots. When spots are all in a line, like we say dot. And when spots are in every way, then we say spot. So this is female. In this part, the spots are in different, are scattered only. They don't seem to be like in a line. So we accept that it is a male one. Understood now? Now coming to the second part. Jody gave himself over to thought of the fawn. So he was thinking about the how he can bring the fawn back. They passed their abundant clearing. They went inside the forest. He said, "Cut to the north, Pinwheel. It was up here that Bark was bitten by the snake and killed the dog and saw the fawn." So he said, "We will go to the north side because it was the place where we had come found that the fawn and the doe, where doe has been killed and taken, isn't it? And left the fawn there." Suddenly, Jody was unwilling to have Pinwheel with him. If the fawn was dead or could not be found, he could not have been disappointed, see. And if the fawn was there, the meeting would be so lovely and so secret that he would not endure to share it. But at the same time, going to find the fawn, Jody did not want whom to be with the Pinwheel. He did not want Pinwheel to go along with him. Why? Because two reasons is there. What are the reasons? One reason, if he goes and did not find the fawn, he will feel disappointment, isn't it? So he did not want the Pinwheel to know his how much he is disappointed. Understood? Secondly, if that animal is there, he will be very happy. So he did not want to share his happiness to go to Pinwheel. Understood? So these are the two reasons why he wanted to go alone to find the fawn. Understood? Because he did not want Pinwheel to go along with him. Because first reason is that suppose the animal is not found there, he feels disappointed. So he did not want Pinwheel to see his disappointment. Secondly, if the animal is there, so happy, isn't it? So he did not want to share that happiness with the home, with the Pinwheel. He said, "It is not far now, but the scrub is very thick. That means all the bushes are very thickly grown. For the horse, I can make it on foot. That means I will go by walking because it will be very difficult for the horse to move in that place because all the scrubs, all the trees, bushes, everything are being struck over there, which finds the horse difficult for moving. So by foot I can go." That means avoiding Pinwheel. He said, "It is not far now, but the scrub is very thick. For a horse, I can make it on foot. That means I can go by walking. But I am afraid to leave you, boy. Suppose you get lost or get bitten by a snake too." So what did Pinwheel say? "That will be dangerous. That means it is a forest. I am not having that confidence to send you alone. Sometimes you may lose the way, or if any other snake come and bite you. I will take care. It might take me a long time to find the fawn. If you want to leave me or find the fawn." That means I what did he say? He wanted to avoid Pinwheel. So he said, "No, I will take care of myself. And sometimes it takes time to find the animal. Alright, but you take it easy now. You know not here at least." That means Pinwheel was Jody was not willing to take Pinwheel. So Pinwheel understood that and he said, "Okay, now you go to your go with your path only to the towards the north side. There and there the tall pines make a roaring solemn." So the whole area was covered with the pine trees. So long, Minvina was up late amidst very tall trees. He waited for the sound of the hooves to end and then cut to the right. The scrub was still, so he started moving. Only his own trampling hunting sounded across the silent universe, pure silence everywhere. Only the sound what he is making can be heard. It is the forest. He wondered for an instant if he had mistaken his direction. So everywhere, wherever he could turn, he could see the scrubs growth and the pine trees, tall, tall pine trees. So sometimes he thought the way is lost. Then a buzzard rose in front of him. Buzzard, that means a large bird. It came in front and flapped into the air. It came from the air, flapping the wings. He came into the clearing under the oaks. Buzzard sat in a circle round the carcass of the doe. So Typhon had come for taking the flesh of the dead animal. They turned their heads on their long, scanty necks and kissed at him. He threw his bow at them and they flew. The sand showed promise to prince, but the big cats killed the fresh man they had left the door to the cartoon birds. So first it has taken and then slowly, what did he do? He went around to the end of the bird. He parted the grass at the place where he had seen the fawn. He did not see possible. It was only yesterday. The fawn was not there. He circled in the clearing. There was no sound outside. The buzzards packed their wings impatient to return to their business. He returned to the spot where the fawn had emerged and brought them all, studying the sand for the small fawn. The night rain has washed away all tracks except those of cats and buzzards. So only, so the previous night the Jodi has taken the body of the doe had gone. That night what had happened? Rain had come and has washed away all the tracks from there, isn't it? So no footprints were seen on the dead ground because everything has been washed away in that day, heavy rain. And only the birds which had been circling around the dead body, only those footprints were seen. Other was not there. Everything was cleared by the rainwater. Understood? Jodi did not want the main meal with him for two reasons. What are the two reasons? Firstly,
he did not want to show his happiness, how much he
he loved to see that animal over there. Why was Melville afraid to leave Jody alone? So Melville was not willing to leave Jody alone. Why? Because two reasons. One, first one, he can get lost his way, and secondly, if you go to the interior part of Simshana, others naked by sea, it also be dangerous for you, isn't it? So these two answers is compared with the other lesson, other answers. Understood now? Now coming to the third portion. So the first part we have seen that from their mother near, they had left the baby deer over there, killed the mother and left the baby over there, isn't it? And he was not willing to go back without having the baby bear, because he did not want the baby to die of starvation or fear, isn't it? Because it is only a baby. And secondly, he wanted, his father is being saved, and now the left baby was there, he did not want the baby to live over there. So he asked the water permission from his father and mother, and he went to the forest to have it. And there Melville had gone along with him, but at the same time he did not want to show his disappointment with the animal is not there to Melville, and the same did not want to share the happiness also. So these are the four points what we had covered by first part and the second part. Then the third is left, and we will continue for the next episode.